In one of our previous videos, we have already discussed about Mendel's law of dominance. The law of dominance and the law of segregation, both these laws are based on the monohybrid experiment performed by Mendel. So before discussing about the law of segregation, let us take a quick and a brief review about Mendel's monohybrid experiment. This is the monohybrid experiment performed by Mendel. He selected tall and dwarf pea plants. The genotypes of the plants were as follows: capital D and small d for the dwarf plant. The gametes were formed as capital T by the tall plant and small t by the dwarf plant. In F1 generation, Mendel got all tall plants. However, the genotype of these tall plants was capital T and small t. However, in F1 generation, the allele small t is not expressed. This shows the dominant effect of the other allele, that is capital T. The capital T allele gets expressed in the F1 generation, and the expression of capital T suppresses the expression of small t. Hence, he concluded that capital T is the dominant allele and it is dominant over the recessive allele small t. However, in F2 generation, Mendel got both the types of phenotypes, the same phenotypes which he selected for the parents. He got 3 tall plants and 1 dwarf plant, which helps him to conclude that the capital T is dominant, but he did not obtain any of the plant with intermediate stem height. The plants were either tall or the plants were short. However, the intermediate stem length was not obtained. Due to this, he concluded that the capital T and small t allele, though they remain in the same genotype, but they never get mixed up. They get segregated during the time of gamete formation, which you can see here. However, the genotype of the plant was capital T and small t. But during the time of gamete formation, capital T and small t get separated. The same happens with the other plant also. Capital T and small t gametes get separated. They got segregated and they got accommodated in different gametes. This mixture of gametes helped him to get 3 tall plants and 1 dwarf plant. However, all the 3 tall plants were genetically different, which means 2 of the plants were heterozygous and 1 plant was homozygous for tall character. Homozygous for tall character means capital T and capital T. Heterozygous for tall means capital T and small t. But capital T remains expressed due to its dominant effect. And the 4th plant was dwarf. He did not obtain any of the intermediate plants. The stems were either tall or dwarf. No intermediate stem height. Therefore, we concluded that the alleles get separated and they segregate into different gametes during the time of gamete formation. That is all for Mendel's law of segregation. Thank you. Like, share and subscribe to Craig Science Academy.